Hello everyone, in this video I am going to show you how to make your own Lords electronic heart. Let's get started. So here we have our N555 IC we will be using for our project. If you don't know how to count the pin number of this IC, find this notch or this dimple in your IC. We will be counting the pin number from the right side of this notch, or starting from this dimple. We have our pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. Then take a U-turn and count from there. We have our pin 5, 6, 7 and 8. We need two resistances of the value, 470 kilo ohm and a 2.2 kilo ohm resistance. A 470 kilo ohm resistance has a band code of yellow, purple, yellow, and for 2.2 kilo ohm we have red, red and red. We require these two capacitors value for our project. One microfarad capacitor, this is an electrolytic capacitor. These capacitors are polarized, so make sure to put these in correct configuration. And here we have a ceramic capacitor of value 0.1 microfarad. If you wonder how to calculate the value for these ceramic capacitors, you have to multiply the starting two digits with 10 to the power whatever digit you have here and divide it by 10 to the power minus 12, because these capacitors come in picofarad range and 10 to the power minus 12 is 1 microfarad. We require one CTPA lens for our project. If you don't have access to any old CTPA to get one from, just go to your local scrap store and you'll find loads of CTPA, because with increasing EVS concentration, this type of component is very easy to find. With every CTPA lens, you will find four wires coming out of it, a pair for horizontal movement and a pair for vertical movement. These wires coming out from these coils, one winded in this position and one winded in this position. And they are connecting to these pads using these flexible wire, which is also used for suspending the lens in air. When we pass current through these coils, they interact with these neodymium magnets and move according to their position. This coil moves the lens in vertical positions and this coil moves the lens in horizontal positions. Other than that, we require soldering wire and soldering iron, some super glue, a TP4056 charging module and a Nokia BL5C battery or any equivalent. These battery doesn't come with any short circuit and over voltage protection, so make sure the TP4056 module you will be buying comes with a MOSFET chip and a controller chip for short circuit and over voltage protection. We also require a PCB board or a perf board and some thread to cover our battery, just to make it a bit pretty.
I have used NE555IC in a stable multivibrator configuration. Here is the circuit for the same. If it is hard for you to follow along with this video, you can go to my Hackaday page and find a step-by-step tutorial with detailed explanation. You can find the link for that in the description below.
Here I have completed the circuit on this breadboard. I have connected 1 microfarad capacitor between pin 1 and 2, 0.1 microfarad capacitor between 5 and 6, 470 kilo ohm resistance between 6 and 7, 2.2 kilo ohm resistance between pin 7 and 8, and I have connected pin 2 directly to pin 6 and 4 directly to pin 8. And I have also connected this LED to pin 3 and 1. Before connecting the lens to the perf port, make sure you have connected the lens in correct polarity. Yes, this coil has a polarity. Here I have connected this lens in a wrong way, because it is moving down, 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 but we want it to move up, up and up. Here I have connected the lens in correct polarity. It's moving up, 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 and it feels so good in hand. Yeah, it's so good.
One of the crucial part of this project is the placement of all the components we have already talked about. Like, here's our NE555IC connected to some other passive components like 1 microfarad capacitors for 70 km resistance, 0.2 km resistance to 0.1 microfarad capacitors. Then we have our TP4056 charging module, which we have used to charge our battery. Now that you have all the information needed to complete this project, make it, customize it, and impress your friends. That was my earnest attempt to explain the making of Lord's Electronic Heart. Tell me in comments what type of projects you want to see in future. Until then, stay curious.